Hi everyone, this is Alexander Antsipov, and in this video I'm going to show how to add autocomplete component into mobile application. First, let's create a new IONIQ4 application with name autocomplete app. Now let's open screen 1, and of course you can add autocomplete functionality manually. To do it, you can add, for example, search component, then list component, and implement all logic which, for example, will refresh list component depends on changing value of our search component. But it sounds rather complicated, and there is more simple way. Let's add API plugin with name autocomplete. So here we see that autocomplete screen was added, and it is not complicated to guess that this autocomplete returns states by name. And of course, first let's test how this plugin works. So let's change the routing from screen 1 to autocomplete and test. Application is ready, and now let's try to type some name of the state, for example California, and after selecting state, here we see the name of state and its abbreviation. Now let's take a look how this plugin works. For that, let's open autocomplete screen. Here we see that HTML component is used and image component is inside of this HTML. And now let's take a look on the code of our HTML component. So here we see that all children's of HTML component is wrapped in span component with ngf false. And it means that this image component will not be displayed in the preview and in mobile application. So this image is used only for displaying some image in the preview mode. And below we see that ION autocomplete component is used. More about this component you can read in documentation. So it is third-party component, it is not an API component, but documentation is rather good. And in order to add this component into your project, it was needed to add corresponding npm module. So it was added on app setting and then in npm module section. Now let's go back to autocomplete screen. And also here we see that data provider property was specified with value states dictionary. Now let's open code and then variable. So here we see that states dictionary has type state dictionary, and it is a TypeScript service where it is specified the list of all states in the United States with the abbreviation, and also getResult method is implemented, which accept one parameter, keyword, and then return the list of states based on keyword. And last, what we have to know about this component is item selected method, which is invoked when some state is selected. So let's open functions. Here we see that this function applied only one argument with name event. And as you already guessed, this event is a selected state. So here we see that there is a state variable, and in design we display state name and state abbreviation. In case, for example, if you need to change states on something different, for example, the goods of your store, everything what you will have to do just to open states dictionary and provide your data. As that is all what I wanted to show in this video. If you like it, please subscribe to the channel. If you have any questions or suggestions, please leave them in the comments.